Colleyville Synagogue is getting ready to welcome back its members nearly 3 months after a terrorist incident. Hello, I'm Steve Eager.
Hello, everybody. I'm Heather Hayes. In January, British national Malik Akram took four people hostage for 10 hours at Congregation Beth Israel, demanding the release of a Pakistani woman imprisoned in Fort Worth. One hostage was released. The others escaped as FBI agents stormed in and killed Akram. Fox 4's Lynn and Wynn joining us now from Colleyville with a look inside that synagogue. Lynn.
Yes, Steve and Heather, over the last few months, the congregation has been gathering at other nearby churches, but congregation leaders tell us they are very excited to welcome families back home this weekend.
We are looking forward and we're trying very hard. I'm a little overcome by the excitement of this weekend.
With the events of January 15th now behind them, Congregation Beth Israel is focused on moving forward.
This is really the big piece now, is that we've moved past the event that happened, and now we're talking about where's our congregation going to go forward from here.
There are new repairs to stained glass windows and the Tree of Life, all damaged when the standoff ended with FBI agents storming the synagogue, using a stun grenade and shooting the hostage taker with no injuries to anyone else.
The bullets exploded that glass with big holes and big damage. So that's all been replaced now, and the damage was repaired.
Many of the repairs donated by local contractors. The halls and rooms now decorated with messages of love and support from the North Texas community and worldwide, with notes from as far away as Japan.
And it's so important that this kind of love, without any sort of ask, we didn't ask anybody to do this.
Thursday, three of the men taken hostage during that hours-long standoff, Rabbi Charlie Citron Walker, Jeffrey Cohen, and Lawrence Schwartz, all returned to the synagogue with excitement and getting ready to welcome everyone back.
I am so excited to be coming back and to be coming in here and with everything that's going on. Very much looking forward. And that's part of that processing.
With a welcoming message of inclusion for all.
We want to be friends with you. We want you to be friends with us. We're all one family. And we certainly proved it on this event.
It could have gone a different way. We could have felt so much worse. It could have been so much worse. All of that love and support that we received, that meant the world to us and our community.
And around 200 people are expected back here for services on Friday and Saturday. There will also be a rededication of the building tomorrow.